Good morning, children. Today we are going to study the fifth chapter of geography. The name of our chapter is Major Domains of the Earth or the Major Part of the Earth. There are four major parts of the Earth. They are lithosphere, atmosphere, hydrosphere and biosphere. In this chapter, we will study what are the peculiarities of these major domains of the Earth. First, let us understand about lithosphere. Lithosphere is the solid crust of the earth and it is mainly made up of rocks. Okay. The place where we stand or the place on which we stand is lithosphere. Okay. It contains two major bodies. One is land body and second one is water body. The land body is called continents and the water body is called oceans. Let us understand about the continents. There are seven major continents of Earth. First one is Asia. In your textbook, page number 31, you can see. Okay, that yellow color part is called Asia. It is the biggest continent. India is in Asia. Okay, Tropic of Cancer, that one line passes through Asia. Okay, then second one is Europe. That lavender color part is called Europe. As you know, England, France, Germany, all these countries are in Europe. Okay. Then let us understand about Africa. In your textbook, page number 31, that green part of is called, in your that map, green part is Africa. Africa is the second biggest continent after Asia. Okay. And three important lines or three important latitudes. A Tropic of Cancer, Equator and Capricorn passes through Africa. Okay, Tropic of Cancer, Capricorn and Equator pass through Africa. The major, biggest and hottest desert in the world, Sahara, is in Africa. And the Nile, longest river in the world, Nile, is also in Africa. Then next one is North America. That orange color is North America. Tropic of Cancer. Okay, as you know, Tropic of Cancer latitudinal value is 23.5 degrees north latitude. That is called Tropic of Cancer passes through North America. Then South America, Brazil, Argentina. Okay, these important countries are in South America. Two latitudes there. Equator and Tropic of Capricorn pass through South America. Then Australia. Australia is the smallest continent. Okay, it is entirely in southern hemisphere. And next one is Australia is also called island continent. Okay, then Antarctica is entirely in southern hemisphere. The two continents are in southern hemisphere. Fully southern means they are Australia and Antarctica. Okay, it is fully, as you know, it is exists in polar region. It is very cold. There are two research centers in Antarctica. They are Maitri and Dakshina Gangotri. India's two major research centers in Antarctica. They are Maitri and Dakshina Gangotri. Then lithosphere is completed. Then let us see about hydrosphere. The major water domain is called hydrosphere. It is completely filled with water. That means the earth is 71% of earth is water and 29% of earth is land. Because of the major part of earth is covered with water, that is why earth is also called blue planet. Okay. Then the large water body is called ocean. Okay, let us study about what are the important oceans of the world. Pacific Ocean, as you know, biggest ocean in the world. Okay, biggest ocean, Pacific Ocean. Then next one is Atlantic Ocean. The busiest ocean is Atlantic Ocean. It is S-shaped. Okay, it is between Asia or Europe and America. It is S-shaped and busiest. Then Indian Ocean. Okay, the ocean which is named after a country is Indian Ocean. The only ocean which is named after a country is Indian Ocean. Okay, and the Arctic Ocean is the smallest. Okay, it is entirely in northern poles, northern part of the. See, there are the these are the major hydrosphere. Okay, oceans, major oceans. Then let us somewhat understand about atmosphere. What is atmosphere? The blanket of air covering the earth is called atmosphere, or the atmosphere is made up of earth. Okay, there are five major part of atmosphere. The lowest part of the atmosphere is called troposphere. Can see page number 35. There is one picture, or I will show you this picture. The lowest part is called troposphere. All the climatic changes happen in troposphere. Then the layer above troposphere is called stratosphere. It is cloud free. There is no any climatic changes. Therefore, jet planes travel through this. Okay, so jet planes travel through stratosphere. Then the layer above the stratosphere is called mesosphere. Okay, meteorites, comets burn in this layer. Okay, mesosphere. The layer above mesosphere is called thermosphere. Thermosphere, radio transmission is possible because of this thermosphere. Okay, we will transmit the from the radio stations. We transmit the programs to satellites. Then this go to satellites in the thermosphere and reflect back to our houses in the radios. So radio transmission is possible because of the thermosphere. And the layer above thermosphere is called exosphere. Then the fourth domains of the earth is biosphere, the domain of life, the place where these four major domains come to join together and provide life. This is called biosphere. Okay, the area or the narrow zone, only some area, the area in which these four major domains, that is land, water, air and land, water, air and life exist together is called biosphere. Okay, here we can see the plants and human beings live. Okay, so biosphere is the domain of life, biosphere. So in this chapter you understand about four major domains of the earth, that is lithosphere. Lithosphere means made up of rock part of the earth. Okay, here two parts are there. One is continent and another one is ocean. The hydrosphere is fully made up of water. Okay, water. This water body is called ocean. 71% of the earth is water. Therefore, earth is called blue planet, as you know. Okay, biggest ocean is Pacific Ocean. And you can see Indian Ocean, Atlantic Ocean, Arctic Ocean, etc. Then the next one is atmosphere. Surroundings made by air is called atmosphere. Okay, five parts are there: troposphere, stratosphere, mesosphere, mesosphere and thermosphere. Okay, troposphere, stratosphere, mesosphere, thermosphere and exosphere. These are the five parts of atmosphere. Then biosphere, the place where there is life is called biosphere. Okay, now let us write the notes. Now all of you take your notebook and write chapter 5, major domains of the earth. What are the major domains of the earth? The four major domains of the earth are lithosphere, atmosphere, hydrosphere, biosphere. Second question, name the major continents of the earth: Asia, Europe, Africa, North America, South America, Australia and Antarctica. Name the two continents that lie entirely in the southern hemisphere: Australia and Antarctica. Name the different layers of the atmosphere: troposphere, stratosphere, mesosphere, thermosphere, exosphere. Why is the earth is called the blue planet? The earth is called blue planet because more than 71% of the earth is covered with water. Why is the northern hemisphere is called land hemisphere? The northern hemisphere is called the land hemisphere because the greater part of the land mass lies in the northern hemisphere. Why is biosphere important for living organisms? The biosphere is the narrow zone of contact between the land, water and air. It is in this zone there is life. So this is end of the class. Thank you, children.